Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna share with you how I'm gonna do the review of this nail set. This is like kind of like a gel X nail, but it's a 123 gold from Inner Couture. Last time I did this nail set, so mostly on my channel I always share with you the new set most of the time, so I thought that would be nice if I would share with you how I do this infill. So if you sometimes you don't have time to soak it off, you're just gonna do it this way. So the first thing I do right here, just remove all the gel color on top of your nail first, and then after that you're gonna starting to take off any of the lifting, and this is a really important thing to do. As you can see right here, I have a little lifting right there. So what I do, I will use the drill bit to tap 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 right there where the lifting it, kind of like tap it backwards so it will starting to come off, and do this really slow and carefully. Well, this nail set, I didn't have a lot of lifting, so yeah, it wasn't that bad. It's kind of like 2 week set, so it's not too long. So the next thing I do right here is push back the cuticle and clean out the cuticle with this cuticle bit. I got it from Amazon. So right here, I'm doing it forward, and I also twist it to reverse and do it to the left, to the right, just to make sure that I clean out all of that cuticle right there, the dead skin. So the next thing I do is just trim off any of cuticle that I pushing it up. As you can see, I haven't do this for a while, so I have a lot of cuticle here, and I do the same thing to the rest of the finger. And the next thing, I'm applying the hydrator and primer. So, and then from here, we just do it just like how we're gonna do any nail set. Today, I'm gonna do the Aurora nail. So the way it is, it's kind of like a little bit different. But if you just do the infill like that, and then applying the gel color on top again, then you would just use either builder gel. Or poly gel, it's optional. You can use either one, which one that you like to work with better. And just applying the builder gel around the cuticle area. So before you do that, you do the same thing how I'm doing right here, applying some base coat. So today I'm using the 3-in-1 Burano, and so far I'm really in love with this one. They actually really nice. They help the nail last longer, and the consistency is really thick, kind of like a builder gel. So yeah, applying the base coat, and then you will applying the builder gel, the clear one or the poly gel to fill in the gap where your nail grow out. But today I'm gonna do the Aurora nails, so it's gonna be a little bit different because I have to encapsulate it, the Aurora paper. So this paper right here, I got it from Amazon, and it came with a lot of different color. Really nice. Like, I love the way they are look. They absolutely beautiful. So comment down below if you can wanna see me try the Aurora nail with a different color, because today I'm just picking a really popular color when it comes to Aurora nail, kind of like a pink purple look. And this is my first time trying it this way out, so I'm a little bit struggling. It doesn't seem like it's easy like how I look. I mean, especially this part when I was trying to cut the nail, the Aurora paper into the nail shape that I have, and I was struggling. It's so hard to cut the piece of that paper out of the almond shape. So yeah, it took me a little while, and it took me a lot of try. So this first time I was kind of like a little bit fail. As you can see, the paper, I cut it a little bit too big, so that make the side of the paper kind of like folding. So after I doing this nail set, I'm learn from it, from mistake that I made. So I recommend if you guys wanted to try out this type of nail, the paper, the Aurora paper, you're gonna cut it smaller. Keep it nice and straight, just in the middle part of your nail only. Don't let it stick out too much. So this first time I tried, it was kind of like a fail because first of all, the paper I cut a little bit too big, and second of all, somehow after I'm done it, whereby when I'm encapsulate the paper right here, you can see I use the IBD gel today, and when I finished encapsulate it have a lot of bubble. And I didn't like it. I want the nail to be as clear as I can to show the effect of the Aurora paper. But somehow maybe I was moving the brush around too much because it's not just flow the gel like how I usually do. You have to do on the side around of the Aurora paper first, and then you encapsulate it on top of the paper. So somehow it get a lot of bubble, like a little bubble, so I didn't like the way it turned out. So after this first try, I kind of file it down and try it again, but I still want to share with you guys because especially every time you want to try something new, you can make mistake and you can learn from it. So I want to share with you my experience, you know what I did wrong, and you know we can make it better next time. So that's how they are look like. I know it closely, I mean far away you can't see the bubble, but yeah, closely it's really bad. So this is the second time I'm trying it again. So what I do right here, I applying some non-wipe top coat and I cure in the lamp for 60 seconds. And I'm gonna use this chrome today from Inel Couture. It's Aurora chrome. And I'm gonna rub it on top of that top coat so it's kind of like a base for the nail before I applying the Aurora paper. And the chrome looks okay. I mean, I thought it's gonna be a little bit prettier, but it's okay, you know, just to have something there because this time I'm cutting this paper kind of like smaller. Just keep it in the middle of the nail, so on the side, kind of empty. So with the chrome underneath, it kind of like have a little bit more effect, you know, on the side. It doesn't look too empty. So right here, I'm applying a thin layer of the IBD gel just to have something underneath before I'm putting that Aurora paper on top. And I was struggling when I cutting this paper because the scissor that I use is a cuticle scissor and they have a little curl on the top, so that's why it was so hard for me to try to make the paper into the almond shape. But at the end, you know, I kind of cut my nail off, but yeah, we get there in a little bit. So I learned is that if you are doing this nail, try to use the scissor that are straight. I think the straight scissor will actually easier for you to cut it into whatever the shape you want. Yeah, because the one I use, the curl one for the cuticle, and it didn't end well. It was so hard for me to do it. So right here you can see I'm encapsulating the nails. So what I learned after I do the one on the side, I kind of flash cure the nail a little bit for like maybe 10 seconds. So the paper, Aurora paper, will stay in play for me to encapsulate on top. Yeah, so I'm just encapsulate the whole nails and cure. So this second nail turned out a little bit better. As you can see right there, it's not a lot of bubble. It's more clear now. So I'm gonna do the same thing on the ring finger and I'm gonna speed it up so you can kind of see again, you know, apply the layer on the bottom, put the paper on top, and do encapsulate on the side of the nail and then on top. So it sounds easy, but it's not that easy. And hopefully next time I will do better. You know, practice, make it better. And you know, comment down below if you can want to see me trying to do Aurora nail again, but with a different method. Last time I tried, I used Femi Beauty method with this Aurora nail, but it's not the whole big piece. I just do it like a little piece. I will link it down below if you guys wanted to see how that looked like. And I actually really love the way it is, so I think I'm gonna try a different method with the same kind of nail just to see which one better, which one easier. This one is not that easy, and this is the original way that the Korean really popular, and that's how they do it. So I want to try it out, yeah, but it's a little bit hard if you are a beginner. So this middle finger right here, I'm gonna do it with the little piece. So I cut the Aurora paper into a smaller piece, and then I will place it, you know, one right next to each other on the whole nail. So this is kind of like the way I did last time with the Femi Beauty method, but I do it backward, you know, and they look actually really nice. I like the way it turned out. So the same thing, I'm just gonna encapsulate on top of the whole nail, and this is actually so much easier because I don't have to do on the side first. I would just encapsulate the whole nail. As you can see, I put a thin layer first at like a slip, and then I will get a blob of the builder gel, and I float it around, you know, back and forth, until they get to the end of the nail. So this is usually how I do encapsulate it with the builder gel. As you can see, it seems easier, and it is easier, and it turned out really beautiful. That middle finger, I really like the way it looked. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I got this paper from Shein, and it was in the section of foil, transfer foil. So for me, I thought it's a transfer foil, and they look, you know, they have the effect of Aurora paper. So for me, like, that looked really interesting. Like, I love it. I love that. And I wanted to try this nail set with a different effect. So then when I put it on top, and I will rub it right here, but then when I peel it, nothing come out, and that was really disappointing. So I thought, oh, maybe I have it on the wrong side, because you know how the transfer foil, when they have the effect like that, it might be the wrong side, that's why it didn't came out. But nope, it's actually not a transfer foil, it's just the same paper, Aurora paper, just like this one. So I give up on that. So then this I'm gonna do the same effect right here on the index finger and the pinky with the same Aurora paper, but I will kind of like crinch it to make it have like that wrinkle effect. So I would do the same thing, I will put on top and cure a little bit and encapsulate it. And I really, really love the way this finger turned out, the way of the effect of the wrinkle. It looked really beautiful, absolutely beautiful. But there's one thing, is that when you are crunching it up like that, they give that nail a lot of texture, which means when they have a lot of texture like that, when you encapsulate the nail, it's actually harder, because on the side it kind of like not smooth. So I end up encapsulate the nail and make the nail kind of like thicker, if you get what I'm saying. And yeah, so that's how it's be. So let's talk about filing is the worst part for me here, because the nail is so thick. But with this nail, I cannot use the e-file at all, so I have to use hand file to buff them down. And you can see right here, earlier I used the other nail file to smooth it out. I accidentally kind of file off a little piece of that Aurora paper, so even the nail was kind of thick, but then Aurora paper, it's just right there so close, and I couldn't smooth out the nail how I want it to be. So the nail kind of end up still thick, and then there's still some part still kind of bumpy. And that's the fact about I don't like this nail set, just because of that. I'm not a big fan of thick nail. I usually like it thinner, but because encapsulated, I understand it will be thicker. But then I was scared if I file more, I will, you know, do the same mistake on the thumb that I will remove that Aurora paper. So I'll try to file whatever I can to smooth it out. But yeah, it's still kind of bumpy a little bit. As you can see right here, I end up chopping off my nail on the tip to make it coffin shape at the end, because the almond shape didn't really looking that good because the tip is so thick and I don't like the way it looked like that. So I end up, you know, cut them down and try to shave them more coffin. I hopefully it look coffin because they're pretty thick. I mean, my last thought, you know, my final thought is I absolutely love the way of that Aurora paper look. They're absolutely beautiful. But the fact that to do it this way, you know, like the original way how everybody do it, the nail gonna be thick and it's kind of hard to do. So I would definitely try it with a different method. And let's see how that will go. As you can see right here, when I apply the top coat, I also apply underneath the nail because we want this nail look to be more like a clear. So, you know, we do that. So after I cure the nail, apply cuticle oil, and we are done. Yeah, I hope you guys like this video. You know, if you can, you know, hear my experience from this nail set. And I hope you are enjoying it. I know they're not turned out super, you know, beautiful with the nail shape, but the Aurora paper is beautiful. And I hope you guys have a great day. And if you want to see more of my video, something kind of like this, just, you know, my experience about the nails, then comment down below, give it a like, and subscribe to my channel. Ring the bell notifications so you won't miss out any of my future video. And thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you again next time. Bye.